How job automations will accelerate post-COVID-19. If there's anything certain about COVID-19, is that it has absolutely changed the way things are done in our society. And even after it's gone, life on Earth will continue to change progressively. Welcome to the 9-to-5 Rebel, and in today's video, we'll be looking at how job automations will accelerate post-COVID-19. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and to turn notifications on for more incredible videos like this. Without further ado, let's begin. Due to the way COVID-19 spreads, the pandemic has caused a new way of working, with traditional corporate roles being relegated to a remote setting and birthing also new processes such as remote hiring. For tech-savvy recruiters who want to make their own lives a little bit easier, there's a whole array of new options to hire new members for their companies. From automated applicant tracking systems, to video-based interview platforms, to gamified skills assessments, to simulations of on-the-job scenarios using virtual reality. All of these can take place in a remote environment too. The economic crisis arising from the pandemic has caused a slowdown in hiring for some companies, and also retrenchment for many others. However, the need for new technology that helps adjust to the changes in the talent market is still very much there. After all, exposing essential workers to some tasks that also require them to be in contact with other people on a constant basis risks them getting infected with COVID-19. It's much better to use robots and artificial intelligence instead of workers that don't risk getting infected, or infecting others for that matter. During downturns, most companies invest in automation to save on labor costs, which is very helpful too. Machines have made jobs obsolete ever since the Industrial Revolution. The spinning jenny replaced weavers, buttons displaced elevator operators, and the internet drove travel agencies out of business. Job automation caused 400,000 jobs to be lost in US factories from 1990 to 2007. However, the drive to replace humans with machinery is now not motivated by anything other than preventing workplace infections and keep its operation costs low. The US shed around 40 million jobs at the peak of the pandemic, and while some have come back, some will never return. One group of economists estimates that 42% of the jobs lost are gone forever. After destroying tens of millions of American jobs, with many of them not coming back, companies and experts alike are uncertain on how the labor market will look like in 6 months or 10 years. Only due to COVID-19, robots could replace as many as 2 million more workers in manufacturing alone by 2025. According to a recent paper by economists at MIT and Boston University, and as explained by Time magazine, the pandemic has also created a very strong incentive to automate the work of human beings. Machines don't fall ill, they also don't need to isolate to protect peers, and they don't need to take time off work. However, this wave of automation will be harder for different people, especially low-wage workers. Many Black and Latino Americans are cashiers, food service employees, and customer service representatives, which are among the 15 jobs most threatened by automation, according to McKinsey. Even before the pandemic, the global consulting company estimated that automation could displace 132,000 Black workers in the US by 2030. Robots were quickly employed by companies as a response to the COVID-19. Now they were used to clean floors at airports and also take people's temperatures. Chowbotics manufactured Sally, a salad-making robot used to replace dining hall employees. Malls and stadiums bought Nightscope, a group of security guard robots used to patrol empty real estate. Companies that manufacture in-demand supplies, such as hospital beds and cotton swabs, sought the service of industrial robot supplier Yaskawa America to double up on their production. On top of that, most call centers closed and began using chatbots created by technology company LivePerson or to AI platform Watson Assistant. However, many believe that this was bound to happen anyway, and chatbots were going to be used sooner or later. It's true that the pandemic has accelerated many businesses and industries quite a few years into the future, and the workforce is the one affected the most by it. Let's take a look at other countries and how they have reacted to it. Japanese leaders and countries, for example, have greatly promoted productivity improvements to drive economic growth in their countries. It's been an even greater priority due to the country's low birth rates and rising life expectancy, which have reduced its domestic workforce to 59.7% of the total population. Even with efforts to hire more women, retirees, and foreign workers to boost the labor pool, Japan's demographic shift threatens to stall GDP growth for the next decade. The key to sustained economic growth is not just finding workers, but also transforming how they work through automation. The COVID-19 pandemic has made this even more urgent, with the pandemic accelerating a shift towards digitization to reduce the spread of the virus while also enabling more people and processes to move online. Japan and other Asian countries are likely to face a shortage in labor supply too. Companies have to compensate for the challenge of a shrinking workforce while still having to deliver more. Prior to the pandemic, Japan was on track to automate 27% of existing work tasks by 2030. While that could replace the jobs of 16.6 million people, it would cause 1.5 million workers to lose their jobs. On top of that, the tight labor market could make it difficult for employers to free up people and resources to develop the new growth opportunities that could emerge with automation. Does automation have any other benefits besides preventing infection, though? Automation and artificial intelligence already existed before the pandemic, so it wasn't designed with the sole purpose of preventing infection. It seems like that's just a useful byproduct, rather than an intended advantage or purpose for it. Automation and artificial intelligence free humans from dangerous or boring tasks so that they can take on more intellectually stimulating assignments, helping companies boost their productivity and also raising worker wages. And in the past, technology was deployed piecemeal, giving employees time to transition into new roles. Those who lost jobs could seek retraining, perhaps using severance pay or unemployment benefits to find work in another field. Ironically enough, the new job automations will also open up some new job opportunities to manage the automations in the first place. Along with demand for more data scientists, there will be a need for people with skills in technology, analytics, and business to translate automation into innovation and growth. Employers will also need to incorporate skills training into the jobs of existing employees and work with government agencies to encourage more labor force participation while minimizing disruption, especially to vulnerable populations. Managers cannot lead a revolution that they don't understand. Senior executives need to enhance their own digital capabilities to drive change from the top. That means learning about the implications of digitization, machine learning, and artificial intelligence, AI, for their businesses. In the past, most countries responded to technological change by investing in education first. When automation changed, for example, farm jobs in the late 1800s and the 1900s, states expanded access to public schools. Access to college also expanded after World War II with the GI Bill, which sent around 7.8 million veterans to school from 1944 to 1956. Since then, U.S. investment in education has stalled, which put the burden on workers to pay for it themselves. The country spends 0.1% of GDP to help workers navigate job transitions, less than half of what it spent 30 years ago. That means that the real automation problem isn't the robot apocalypse itself. Rather, it's that most governments have no idea how to actually help the workforce transition from traditional work to the new normal. So what do you think of these job automations that will accelerate post-COVID-19? Have you noticed automation affecting your field of work? Let us know in the comments. Also, don't forget to leave us a like, share this video with your friends, and also subscribe to our channel for more incredible videos like this. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.